You can go ahead.
Have you ever craved something sweet and delicious but didn't know what to make? I've been in this situation, and the one thing that always helps me is my grandma's brownies. They're simple to make and only take a few steps. The first thing you want to do is wash your hands, which I've already done, and then you want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. Then you need to get out all your supplies and your ingredients, which includes a bowl to mix in, an 8x8-inch pan, a whisk, napkins, oil, a bowl to melt butter in, and then your ingredients, which includes a half a cup of butter, 2 eggs, a teaspoon of vanilla, and then your dry ingredients, which I've already made in a bag, and you can keep that in a bag and store it up to 6 months, which includes a half a cup of flour, half a cup of white sugar, half a cup of brown sugar, a third of a cup of cocoa, a fourth a cup of baking powder, a fourth a teaspoon of salt, and a half a cup of chocolate chips of your choice. So first you want to take your oil and just dump a little drop in your pan, like so, that much. And take a paper top and wrap it around the pan so your brownies don't stick to the pan when you bake them. And then you want to take your butter, which I've already melted, and pour it in your bowl. And then take your 2 eggs and crack them into the bowl, but make sure not to get any shells in there. And then your teaspoon of vanilla. And then dump your dry ingredients in. And if you want to get out your handout while I mix this up, it'll show you, it talks about the history of brownies and where they came from and why they were made in the first place. And then you want to mix your batter so there's no clumps of anything. And then you want to, after it's all mixed, like that, you want to take a pan and dump it all in. And you can use whatever you mixed it with to scrape it out into your pan. Depending on how gooey or how firm you want the brownie to be. And then after you bake it, when you take it out of the oven, you can let it cool, or you can eat them right away. Just depends how warm you want them to be or how cool. After you bake them and leave them set for 5 days, it'll look like this. Now that you know how to make these brownies, next time you have a craving, you can keep these in mind and make them for yourself.
Thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause.
Thank you, Shane.